Hi everyone! Today I will make a very quick flip through of this Escape to Christmas Past coloring book, which I just got as a present from Amy. I know that the book isn't new, but as I prefer to have reviews for all coloring books which I own in the playlist on my channel, it's easier for my followers to look which books I own and to ask me to color something, to make a color along, so I decided to make this video and to share with you reasons why I am so in love with Good Wives and Warriors books. I currently own all but one. I don't have Alice in Wonderland, and I have Shakespeare's Oz and Christmas Past. And of course, first reason is that I really love the artwork. Pictures could look very simple, but I don't know why they are so attractive. Even people around me who are not in love with coloring, but who accidentally look at pictures in this book when I got it, they immediately said that, oh, they are so interesting, such lovely pictures. So the artist skills are amazing. Also, I appreciate fantasy. I wouldn't think that it's possible to invent so many pictures connecting to Christmas Carol book by Dickens. The second thing which I appreciate is the quality of the paper. You know that I color in this book using watercolors, ink tens, and different brands of pencils, and everything behaves really well. So I appreciate the tooth of the paper, quality of the binding, and I really love this warm, creamy color of the paper. The next thing which I really appreciate is size. Especially for the Christmas book. You know that before Christmas we all are kind of busy, so we don't have time for doing a very big projects, but still we want to color something to feel this holiday spirit. And I think that this smaller size book are perfect for Christmas time, just to do smaller projects. So it will be definitely one of my favorites for December, along with the book of Lizzie Mary Cullen. My favorite pictures here are pictures like this one, like cityscapes, and also pictures with fireplace and bakery, which I started recently. But I also appreciate simpler pictures with ornaments, patterns, and even with random objects. Also, I like that some pictures have black background, so it will be easier for me to use my Parashant watercolors. I can imagine that I use blue pearl or silver watercolors to add some shining, some sparkles. I think pictures will look really festive and magical. Also, I like that some pictures are connected to famous song about 12 days of Christmas. I don't know why, but I like this song, and I currently do a stitching project. I continue it from the previous year, and I do 12 ornaments from felt from this song. So it will be also nice to color something like this spread, which has a connection to this song. It's a pity that Good Wives and Warriors stopped to do coloring books. At least I hadn't heard anything about their new projects or upcoming coloring books. And if I'm mistaken, I would be happy to hear about it. So if you have some information, please leave me a comment. I think that their books are amazing both in artwork and in quality. This bakery picture I selected as my first project from the book as a part of my Christmas in July. I hadn't decided yet, do I want to color something else during summertime, or maybe I will leave it until November, I think. But now, thanks to wonderful presents which I got recently, I already had a huge plans for the Christmas time. I want to color winter pictures from Tomoko Tashiro books, the Snow Queen from Selina Fanning book, also to color in this one, so we will have a very busy time before Christmas. I wanted once more to say thank you to Amy who sent me this beauty. I hope that you will be coloring in this book together with me. I think that book is quite popular and a lot of you have it in your collections. And I would also like to know which other Christmas books you like and you own and which are worth to purchase. Please leave me a comment with your suggestions. Happy coloring to all of you and participate in Christmas in July!